Welcome students to one more session of your NCERT numerical. Right, hope you would have watched the earlier videos. I have done almost 10 NCERT numericals. Now watch that video and then come back to this. So students, what I'm observing is you're not concentrating or you're not trying to do the numericals along with me. If you're not doing it now, those who are preparing for the competitive exams or those who are preparing for CBSE, try to complete on the daily basis. If you don't do it, you'll struggle it at the end. Right, that's an important suggestion from my side. Let's start. So here, this is 6.11 of your NCERT. Let's read. Enthalpy of combustion of carbon to carbon dioxide is -393.5 kilojoules per mole. Calculate the heat released upon formation of 35.2 grams of carbon dioxide from carbon and dioxygen gas. Nothing simple actually. Let's note what is given to us first. They've given enthalpy of combustion of carbon to carbon dioxide is so much, right? Now whenever such question is given, try to write the reaction first. Enthalpy of combustion means the amount of energy released when carbon is combusted. Okay, combusted means burning in the presence of oxygen. So carbon plus oxygen, right? The physical states, this is solid, this is gaseous. So what do I get? They said they have given carbon dioxide, so carbon dioxide. This is again in gaseous state. Here delta H value, because enthalpy of combustion is delta HC, isn't it? So how much is this? This is nothing but 393.5 kilojoules per mole. Kilojoules per mole. Now, I have to find, how should I find? I should find the heat released upon 35.2 grams of carbon dioxide, right? Basically, when I say 1 mole of carbon dioxide, how much is that? Say 44 grams, isn't it? So, 44 grams, we got delta H value, how much? This one. Now, what are they asking us? They're asking what, calculate the heat released upon 35.2 grams of carbon dioxide, right? It is simple, right? Now, I'm finding for 2 grams of carbon dioxide, how much is the heat released? That's it, simple as it. So for 44 grams, so much heat is released. 35.2 grams, how much is the heat released? So multiply, this becomes equal to 393.5 kilojoules into 35.2 divided by 44 grams. Okay, grams, which is equal to, if I multiply and divide, I get 314.8 kilojoules, right? Gram gets cancelled, right? So this is per mole. Basically, this is 395.1 per mole. So the same thing, 314.8 kilojoules per mole. This is your answer. So hope students you're clear with this concept. Let's see the next question. Now let us do 6.12 of your NCERT numerical. Right, let's read. What here, what did they give us? Enthalpies of formation of carbon monoxide, that is given her. Here, carbon dioxide is given to us, N2O, nitrous oxide is given to us, and N2O4 are given. So 1, 2, 3 given, right? So here, what actually, and N2O4 are. So here, let's see what is given, what is not given. 94.3, okay, respectively. Find the value of delta HR. Okay, what is delta HR basically, right? So I need to find this. Let's write delta R HR. What is this called? Nothing but here. Okay, I'm sorry. This is heat of a reaction. Heat of reaction. Okay, I should find that. And this whole reaction is given to us. Let's find, first find the solution. I said we need to find delta HR. What is the formula which we have learned already? It is nothing but delta HR is equal to, it is nothing but summation of formation of the products minus, this is what you've studied, minus summation of formation of reactants. So this is the formula which you have already learned, isn't it? So the summation of formation of the products minus summation of formation of the reactants. Right. So first of all, let us note the reaction. What is the reaction given? N2O4 gaseous state plus carbon monoxide gaseous state 3 moles gives me N2O gaseous state plus 3CO2 gaseous state. Right. Now these are the reactants part, these are the products part, isn't it? Yes. So now I'm applying the same thing. Let us write the values. So they said products minus reactants. So products, how much N2O is given here? This whole thing minus product. Okay, let us first write this whole thing in this way. So what do I get? I get, put a square bracket, delta HR naught. So N2O is a product plus 3 into, you need to copy with the coefficients. Okay, 3 HR naught, isn't it? 3 delta H naught R, that is your carbon dioxide, which is there. Close this bracket now. Okay, this also will put round bracket, minus of, yeah, products are over. Now you have reactants. Reactants are concerned. This products are written here, reactants I'm writing here. Reactants are nothing but delta formation. Okay, right. Here also you should write not reaction, it is formation only, both the sides, because formation, formation only. Right. Now here when it comes to this one, delta formation of the products, delta formation of the reactants also, okay, isn't it? Yes, this is delta F, right? I'm sorry for that. So delta formation of reactants is what now? It is into O4, okay, plus 3 into CO, okay. Close that. So products minus reactants. So how much is the value given here for into? It is nothing. How much is given? It is 81, isn't it? Yes. So normally into O4 value, right? This is okay. The H naught is 81. This one. This is for carbon. Into O is the third one. 81 plus 3 into, next this value is minus 393, okay, 393, this is close, square bracket, minus of 9.7 for this one, 9.7 plus 3 into minus 110, okay, give it, this is the thing, okay, right, if all the values are given, so everything I've taken up, now we'll add, multiply and everything. Finally, I get minus 777.7 kilojoules, which is approximately minus 778 kilojoules. So this is your answer. So hope students, you're clear. Enthalpies of formations are given everywhere according to the formula. I've applied in the formula and finally got the answer. Right. Let's see the next reaction. 6.13. What did they give me? Given nitrogen plus hydrogen gives me ammonia. Okay, delta H naught of the reaction, that is reaction of enthalpy or enthalpy of reaction. This enthalpy reaction is minus 92.4 kilojoules per mole. Yes, so fine. So what should I find out? What is the standard enthalpy of formation of ammonia gas? Now let's write the reaction. Always, whenever such question is going, write the reaction. Nitrogen plus 3 hydrogen. This is gaseous state. This is also gaseous state, which gives 2 ammonia gaseous state. Now how much is this? Delta naught HR is equal to minus 92.4 kilojoules. Now what are they asking? What is the standard enthalpy of formation of ammonia, they said. So basically, chemical reaction for the enthalpy of formation, now when I have to write the formation of enthalpy, what is this basically? It is nothing but okay, nitrogen is half gaseous state, normal, the basic reaction. Now, hydrogen is 3/2, this gives ammonia, okay, right? So this is in gaseous state. So what is delta H formation now? H naught, or you can write here also, which, how much is this? It is nothing but minus 92.4/2. Why did I do this? See here, this 2 and this 2 gets cancelled. So I get 1. This 2 and this 2 gets cancelled, I get 3. Suppose again 2 and 2 were there, if I cancel, I get 1. That means what do we do? We have given half of this. This is given delta H reaction, half of that is delta H formation, which comes to minus 46.2 kilojoules per mole. That's it. Simple, isn't it? Yes. Let's see the next question, students. 6.14. Right. Let's come back and do question number 14th of your NCRT. Let's read this question. What do they give us? Calculate the standard enthalpy of formation. What is standard enthalpy of formation? Basically, when I have to write the representation, standard means, okay, enthalpy of formation, delta. It is formation, they said. That is nothing but F. Enthalpy is H naught. H naught is standard. Of which one? Of methanol I need to find from the following data. So there's one equation given here. Methanol and combustion gives carbon dioxide and water. The heat of the reaction is so much. Then they, what do? They've already again given the two-step reaction. What is that? First, carbon combines with oxygen, giving carbon dioxide. Hydrogen combines with half molecule of oxygen, giving water. Okay, again they've given heat of combustion, standard heat of combustion for carbon and standard heat of formation for water molecule, right? So how should I find? When such reactions are given to you, try to number the reactions. This is the main reaction, isn't it? Now this is reaction 1, this is reaction 2, okay? Right, so now what are we going to do? First important thing is, if you wish, you can start from here also, not a problem. You can start, this is 1, this is 2 and this is 3, okay? Now what should you do? I need to find delta H naught for methanol. Now see both the reactions. What do we have here? Methanol we don't have here. Okay, I need to find that. Oxygen is here. Here we have carbon dioxide. We have water molecule. But here water molecule is only one mole, isn't it? But here it is 2 mole. So the first step what you should do is, first you are going to multiply, just see, multiply equation 3 by 2. Then you will get 2, this one, isn't it? Let's see. Take equation 3, hydrogen, gaseous state, plus half oxygen, gaseous state, gives us water molecule liquid. Now multiply this whole thing by 2. What will happen now? This will become 2H2 plus this 2 and this 2 gets cancelled, isn't it? So this becomes only O2, gaseous state. Okay, then this comes, this 2 goes here. So I've got 2 water molecules done. Yes, fine. So this reaction is ready. Almost this water molecule is done. Now in the next step, what should I do? Now this is which reaction? Let us name this reaction as 4. Now we will sum up equation 2 and equation 4. Why am I doing that? Because here when I sum up this one and this equation, I have carbon dioxide here. So when I sum up, I get this carbon dioxide along with this water. So this water is already there, carbon dioxide. Let us do. So let us write now, sum up. Summing up means adding equation 2 and equation 4. When I sum up both of them, what do I get? I'm going to get, let us say this is equation 5. So here you'll get carbon. Okay, I'm summing up. See here, carbon plus hydrogen plus oxygen, 2 moles. Let us add and see. So here I'm going to get carbon, which is solid. Hydrogen, when I add both, I get 2H2 gas, then 2 oxygens are there, 2 oxygens which are gaseous state, which give me carbon dioxide, gaseous state, plus 2 water molecules, water. So when I'm adding, even the formations are also added, isn't it? So delta H naught formation, how much do I get when I add this one, this sorry, this one and that one, how much do I get? I'm going to get, after summing up, it is minus 965 kilojoules per mole inverse. Now how much is this one? This is nothing but delta H formation, because I multiplied with that. I need to multiply with this one also. So here I should write that, isn't it? So delta H not HF not is nothing but 572 kilojoules per mole. Okay, now I have added. So I've got minus 965 kilojoules per mole. That's over. Now what I do, I'm going to reverse equation 1. Why? Because I am just trying to get this, because I want methanol formation, isn't it? So this should come the other way. So when I reverse equation 1, what do I get? I get carbon dioxide gaseous state plus 2H2O liquid state, which gives me methanol liquid plus 3/2 oxygen gaseous. So when I reverse this, even the delta H, this information also becomes, instead of minus, earlier it was minus, now this becomes plus 726 kilojoules per mole. Now what am I going to do here? This, let us do the last one. Now I'm going to, let us name this as equation 6. Now what am I going to do? I need to get methanol, isn't it? Now I'm going to add equation 5 and equation 6. Because I have already got methanol on the right hand side. Now I'm going to add. So this becomes carbon is like that. Fine. So 2H2 is like that. Okay. Yes. Then this carbon dioxide and this carbon dioxide gets cancelled, isn't it? So here. Now, next, what is that? Oxygen. Let's see oxygen. Now this is 2O2 and this is 3/2O2. It's nothing but, when I take out, it is half O2, isn't it? So when you subtract, so this becomes half O2 gaseous state. Then what do I get here? This side methanol is here. Yes, So methanol CH3OH, which is in liquid state. This 2H2 and this 2H2 also gets cancelled. So this is how I've got the final equation or final reaction. So students, this is how you're going to do. See what to get, reverse it, add it, and finally get. Fine. So let's come back and do the next question. Oh, I think I have a lot of papers here. Let me take out and let me come back to 6.15. Now again, they're given here, calculate the energy. Okay, let's see this question. Calculate the enthalpy change for the process. So CCl4 is breaking up into carbon plus 4 chlorines. Okay, and calculate the bond enthalpy also I should give. They've given us delta H0 standard heat of vaporization for CCl4, standard heat of formation for CCl4, atomization for carbon. So will delta H0 standard enthalpy of atomization of this one also is given. So how to do about, let's see the question in the next video.